Hey, what's going on, guys? This video is being brought to you by CuriosityStream, the home of award-winning documentaries. They have an unparalleled library of thousands of shows worldwide. If you guys are like me and you love documentaries, nonfiction, you love to be enlightened and educated, CuriosityStream is like nothing else out there. If you decide to check out CuriosityStream, do yourself a favor, check out Man's First Friend. What I love about Man's First Friend is first and foremost, it's beautifully filmed, but more importantly, it is a comprehensive examination of the human relationship with the canine. You guys are watching my channel. This is a video that 99.9% of you guys will enjoy and love as much as I do. In addition, CuriosityStream is running a special right now. If you sign up, you use a coupon code DOGU, D-O-G-U, you'll get your first month free. All right, guys, let's jump into this video.
Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries.
I'm Rachel Manis with All on the Lamb, All Breed Herding in Camarillo, California. So today we are herding with a Rottweiler. This is Baby T the Rottweiler. He is a Grand Show Ring champion. He also participates in agility, dock diving, and lure coursing. This is a very versatile breed. Herding has been a hidden talent of the Rottweiler for over 100 years now. Typically, they're used for police work, protection work, guardian work. People don't realize that they have this in them, but because they are such a sensitive, thoughtful, biddable breed, they're usually surprisingly good at it. The history of the Rottweiler dates all the way back to ancient Rome, when the Roman army was traveling across Europe and they needed to bring food with them. Now, there's no refrigeration, so they were moving entire herds of cattle with them, and their dogs were helping move the cows and protect them at night. Now, the Roman army was moving up through Europe and came to southern Germany, where they founded the town of Rottweil in the year 73. Now, they were trying to keep back the Germanic hordes of barbarians. Fast forward a few hundred years, Rome fell, the barbarians got civilized, and the town of Rottweil was part of a massive, extremely productive cattle raising region, where they were using dogs that descended from those brought in by the Romans to drive their cattle to market. And then once they had their cattle at the market, they needed them to help control the cows and also protect things. They had them pull carts of meat when they were walking through selling it. And merchants would even put their money in a purse around the dog's neck so that the dog could protect their money, because really nobody is going to challenge a Rottweiler. Now, this is one of the oldest breeds, and it was also one of the first breeds to be rescued from extinction, because in the mid-1800s, the railroads took over the job of moving cattle from the countryside into market, and the Rottweiler was going extinct. In 1900, someone realized that there was only one Rottweiler left in the town of Rottweil, and so they had to go looking in the surrounding areas to find more of them and began breeding them back. Fast forward a few more years and you had World War I, where they needed strong, powerful dogs to work in security, to carry messages, and they also became popular police dogs. From there, the Rottweiler has only gotten more popular. In fact, they're usually one of the AKC top 10 breeds today. The Rottweiler is an upright breed. They herd by moving their bodies, barking, and using their imposing size to motivate livestock to move. These days, most people herding with Rottweilers are doing it recreationally, although there are a few people that are using them to move around livestock along with other duties, because they're just so useful and they're also imposing. Nobody is stealing your livestock if you have a Rottweiler. The Rottweiler works similar to other large, powerful herding breeds. You can sometimes find Cane Corsos and Schnauzers, Bouviers, large upright droving breeds. They are not traditional distance workers. They should be working right next to their people, and typically you and your dog would be working behind your flock or your herd, moving them ahead of you. Droving is driving. This is where you are moving your livestock to market. So you're moving them down roads. You need to keep them out of other people's fields and keep them on the road. You need to be able to move them off the road when necessary. And you need to keep them moving and also protect them at night from both predators and thieves. Rottweilers are highly intelligent, and you can see that the way they problem solve while they're working. They're checking every sheep, they're making sure nothing's getting away, and they're also keeping an eye on the surrounding area. Traditionally, Rottweilers are used to move cattle around, but they can also move sheep around because they're just versatile enough that they can do almost anything. They should be patient and confident and responsive enough to their handler that they can move something as delicate as lambs without harming them. Herding helps teach your Rottweiler that it can be around livestock and be around things that trigger their prey drive without attacking them. It teaches them to manage their prey drive, it teaches them self-control and impulse control and how to listen to you when they're around the most exciting thing in the world. For pet owners, herding is a chance to get out of the city, go out and experience something new and different with your dog. It's a lot more fun for the dog than just hiking or walking on trails. It gets your dog and you moving together and working as a team. It's a lot of fun for the dog, and it's a lot of fun for the owner too. Herding is a huge mental workout for a dog. It's a lot of rapid-fire decision-making where the dog is calculating angles and trajectories and planning ahead, and at the same time, they have to listen to you, their handler. So it's a lot of work for the dog, and it really helps settle their mind, give them focus. It can help an anxious dog feel more confident. It can help a busy dog settle down and feel calm. It's a lot like a therapy for dogs. It's very zen for them. The biggest health issues facing the Rottweiler today are potential heart issues and also musculoskeletal issues like hip and elbow dysplasia, which is why it's important to get a dog from health-tested parents. However, those health problems don't prevent them from herding because it's actually a very low-impact activity. It's easy on the hips, it's easy on the elbows, it's not repetitive jumping, and it's not generally high speeds. It allows the dog to move in ways that are comfortable to them. You can do almost any sports with your Rottweiler, and you can do all of the sports with your Rottweiler, except two things that don't mix very well are protection training and herding training. And this is specifically because when you're doing protection training, you generally agitate the dog and teach the dog to bite a sleeve or a bite suit by coming at them waving a stick. And the way we back a dog off of sheep and teach them to give the sheep space is generally by coming at them waving a stick. And that's definitely not something we want to get confused, because I'm not wearing a bite suit out there. So if you do want to do both of these sports with your dog, we recommend that you start with herding. You can start herding training as young as 5 or 6 months old if the dog has aptitude for it. While protection training, you tend to want to wait a little bit closer to maturity. So in general, if you're going to do both, let's start with the herding training. Baby T is a 4-year-old Rottweiler who is currently the number 5 Rottweiler in the country with the American Kennel Club. We met Baby T at a dog show where we were offering herding instinct testing, and he took to it immediately. He's been a very easy dog to train, and he's had about half a dozen lessons, and he's already moving sheep around in a very useful manner. Baby T weighs 120 pounds. He participates in dock diving, in lure coursing, in agility, and in herding. He is a very accomplished dog that really showcases the versatility of this amazing breed. All right, the Rottweiler is a fantastically versatile dog. They can do just about any kind of sport or activity out there, from protection work to therapy work to herding sheep and ducks and cows and anything you can think of. They make fantastic family pets as long as they have proper training, a good owner, and they come from lines where people are breeding specifically for temperament and for breeding very good dogs. They are a breed with a huge, rich history spanning at least 2,000 years, and that's really something to be celebrated. This is Rachel with On the Lam Herding. We're in Southern California. If you have a dog of a herding breed, or even kind of a not-so-herding breed, and you'd like to bring them out to see what they can do, we'd be happy to see you guys. You can check out our website at onthelamherding.com. Come on out and see us.